and see the marching throng and the flood.
Good morning, church. It is so good to be here to worship God with all of you. Just a quick thing I was thinking about. You know, we've been out here doing this for about a year now, pretty close to. And in all that time, it hasn't actually rained on us during a worship service. We've come close a couple of times. It rained before, and then it stopped as soon as we began, or it would start as soon as we were done. But it's never actually rained on us during a worship service for a year. Isn't that amazing? I mean, praise God, we've had such amazing blessings from our Lord in such a strange and difficult year and time to be able to creatively worship God in a different space, and we've just been blessed, and I'm just appreciative of that this morning. And so with that, I think we can handle the little bit of rain we got here this morning today. Amen. And it is Palm Sunday, so hopefully you got your palm leaves on the way in, and you're waving them there in your cars. And friends who are following us online, if the video gets a little bit blurry on you, it's probably because a raindrop dropped in front of the camera, and that's okay. You'll still be able to hear me just fine, and we'll do the best we can today. Amen. All right. Okay, friends, a couple of announcements to start us off today. The Easter flower pickup will be at the church office here on Tuesday or Thursday from 9:30 a.m. until 12:30 p.m. Or on Good Friday, which is April 2nd, before or after the 6 p.m. service. That's going to be here at the church. So they're all listed there in your bulletin. If you ordered flowers, those are your pickup times. The Maundy-Thursday service this year, we just didn't think there was a safe way to do it inside, so we recorded a video that will be published on Thursday there for you. So I encourage you to find that on Facebook or YouTube and to worship from home, that celebrate that Holy Thursday and everything that it means to us. Good Friday, we are still going to plan to have a crosswalk. That's April 2nd. We're going to meet at the Fairview Cemetery at 5 p.m., and we're going to walk with the cross all the way here to the church, reading scripture along the way. And when we get here, it should be about 6 o'clock. And when we get here, we're going to have a small little worship service here to close it out. So if you don't want to come walk, but you want to come up for the worship service, we'll be out here like we are for regular worship services. So feel free to come out at 6 o'clock then for the worship service. And that'll be good. Easter Sunday, we are having an outdoor sunrise service here at the Lake Church at 7 o'clock a.m. If you're one of those bold, ambitious people who likes to get up early and come out to church for an early morning service to see the sunrise and celebrate the rising of our Lord, then come out here at 7 o'clock. But we are still having regular Easter services at 9:15 here like regular, and at 11 o'clock at Falls, just like usual. Church cleanup day is going to be April 17th at 8 o'clock a.m. to do some yard work and general outdoor spring cleaning. So if you're interested in helping out with that, please call Bob Thompson, whose number is listed in your bulletin there. Let him know you're coming so he knows who's coming to help out. We still need mowing volunteers. I know it's not quite ready for it yet, but, I mean, if you want to start signing up now, the sign-up sheet is over here on the bulletin board that's just outside the door behind me over here. So if you're interested in helping mow this year, this summer, put your name on there for a date so that you can help out. That's pretty much all. Everything else is stuff that you see every week in the bulletin. Give it a look in case you've forgotten, and that are the announcements for today. So, friends, will you now join with me in beginning our worship service officially? We're going to start with the call to worship, which is printed in your bulletin. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Open to me the gates of righteousness. This is the gate of the Lord. Amen. Friends, will you join with me in reciting the congregational prayer? O Lord, we thank you because you have answered us and become our salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. So let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Amen, friends. Will you lift up your voices this morning in song, singing verses 1 and 3 of All Glory, Laud, and Honor. Amen, friends. We're going to do a prayer here together like we always do, but I've got a couple things to list off before we go into that prayerful moment. Starting with a joy, a good thing. Y'all might remember seeing Caden running around here on Sunday mornings helping out with handing out bulletins and things like that some weeks. Well, it is his birthday today. It is Caden's birthday, so let me hear that good and joyful noise. Amen. Happy birthday to Caden. Now for some less joyful news. A friend of Christy Clark's, Kim Duffy, passed away yesterday suddenly in her early 40s. She has a 17-year-old son, and we're just in prayer for the Duffy family. This is tragic. It's devastating for everybody, friend and family, who were close to her. Losing life so suddenly is just unspeakably tragic. So please keep the Duffy family in your prayers right now. And also, you all probably know already, but Mary Louise Dodge did pass away, and her viewing is today from 5 to 7 at Litwin in Tunkhannock, and the funeral is tomorrow at 11 if you're interested in showing your support. Those are the dates and times for that. And we're, of course, keeping their family in our prayers as well, and many of us knew and were affected by her passing. Friends, in the midst of all this stuff, in the midst of everything happening in the world, let's bow our heads in an intentional moment of prayer. Gracious and holy God, thank you Thank you for everything, for how you've poured out your Son, Jesus Christ, for us, for how you walk with us here in the midst of our lives and everything that this world has to throw at us. No rain on a Sunday morning can dampen our spirits when we are here in your presence with one another. Thank you for the sending of your Holy Spirit to guide us, to comfort us, to bring us joy, even in the darkest moments. Lord, many of your children are suffering now. As we already lifted up, there are many who are grieving loss, mourning. Lord, we ask that you give them comfort and peace as they mourn, mourning alongside of them. Show us the way to life, your eternal life, through Jesus Christ, your Son. Help us to be your children, to do more good in this world, being your hands and feet, lifting up the downtrodden, being better day by day. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on all your children who are struggling physically with physical ailments. Some of those battles are hard, hard fought, when they need your presence to give them the strength to keep going on. Be a healing presence to them. Take those ailments away that they do not need to fight any longer. Raise up the spirits of all those struggling mentally and emotionally or spiritually today. Help them to see your face and know that you are God and you are with them through everything that they're facing, and that you will not abandon them. Lord, be with all your children, whatever our needs may be. You know everything in our hearts. We lift them up to you today. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen, friends. It may be raining, but we can still make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Let me hear those horns. Here we are. Amen. Peace of God be with all of you and with your spirit today. Let's lift up our voices in song again. Let's sing verses 1 and 6 of All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. He is Lord of all. Today's scripture comes to us from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11, verses 1 through 11. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, why are you doing this? Just say this, the Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately. They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. And as they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, what are you doing untying the colt? And they told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the revelation of the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. It's Palm Sunday, the story of Jesus' triumphant entry into the holy city of God, Jerusalem, where the temple is, during the Passover season, when the Jewish people would all flock to Jerusalem to make their sacrifices and remember how God delivered them from the hands of Pharaoh in Egypt so many years ago. It's a season of liberation, of joy, of celebration, and the Jewish people tended to get a little bit rowdy when this season came to be. And they all huddled together in this city, made quite the crowd, quite the spectacle. And so typically what would happen during this time is the Roman guard, because the Romans were occupying Jerusalem, would increase their guard at this time to try to maintain order, to keep people from getting too out of hand, out of control. And Pilate liked, when he brought in extra guard, he liked to have a parade, a big parade where he would walk in, where he would ride in on a big white horse, displaying his power as he was on a war horse. And he had all these shiny armored men walking all around him with their spears, their swords, the symbols of military might of the Roman Empire, to remind the people, we are here to maintain order. Don't forget that we are here. And it's this kind of parade, this kind of display of power that's being mimicked, being mocked even, by Jesus and his followers as they enter into the holy city at the same time that Pilate's bringing in extra guard and parading his power around. Jesus rides into the city as a humble king, the way the Jewish kings often presented themselves, on a donkey or on a colt. It's a statement about Jesus' kingship, and the people know it. And it looks vastly different from what Pilate had in mind as he entered the city, as he increased the guard. Jesus isn't armed. Jesus is in rags. The only reason he can ride the colt is because everybody puts their jackets on it for him. He doesn't have a fancy, ornate saddle to sit on. And the people, they lay palm branches and coats all along the road for him to walk on as he enters in. And they're shouting, Hosanna! 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 It means roughly, save us! Save us! It has an immediate nature to it. It's almost a save us now, but it's not so demanding. It's a we're ready for salvation now. Bring us salvation now. And the people want saving from many things. They're being occupied by an oppressive force. Rome is not treating the people of Jerusalem well. Not well at all. And they're looking for somebody to run the Roman Empire out of their land. To restore the throne of David, the king of Israel, one of their own, who will rule righteously. This is what they expect. This is what they're expecting from Jesus, but Jesus doesn't make a big military parade out of it, does he? No. It's humble. It's meek. It's mild. Just like Jesus. And Jesus won't deliver them salvation the way they anticipate. But he will deliver them salvation in so much greater a way than they could have ever imagined. And it will come through humble submission, not military force. when Jesus will go to the cross and hand himself over to the forces of Rome to be beaten and hung up there on that tree to utter his final breath. And then eventually, 3 days later, we'll rise up above the death that this world can hand out and show us that we are not bound by the rules or the laws of death, but we are raised up in the new life of God. And what an amazing story it is, and it really begins to happen here at the triumphant entry as the people shout, Hosanna, save us now. We're crying out for salvation too, friends. We know the whole story of Jesus Christ. We've been told we're saved. We've been told salvation is already ours to claim when we call on the name of Jesus. We know that. We've heard it. We know it intellectually. And yet there's still struggling going on all around us, isn't there? Still so much suffering. We're still captive by this pandemic that hasn't quite gone away yet, has it? We're still captive by death to an extent as we continue to mourn as people we love pass on from this world. We still see so much suffering, so much sickness, children abandoned. There's still so much darkness in this world, and so we haven't stopped needing to cry out to Jesus. We're just like the crowd here at the triumphant entry into the city. At the beginning of the Passover season, saying, Lord, save us. Save us now. Show us how we can be your people. Show us the way out of these sufferings. Show us that you're with us, alongside us. And Jesus does, constantly, that we might miss it. If we're not paying attention, because sometimes our expectation of what that salvation looks like might be one thing, and Jesus might be saving us in a slightly different way. Jesus sends us to help one another. Look around for the helpers. Who's doing the work? Who needs the most help? There you'll find Christ. When you reach out to them to lift them up, when you are lifted up, when you're feeling overwhelmed by darkness in your life, who reaches out? It's Christ through them. God working in each and every one of us. We are the church. We are the body of Christ, friends. Yes, the moment of salvation comes from Jesus Christ on the cross in the resurrection. But that work of salvation continues on through each and every one of you. Through all of us who lift each other up, we can help one another out of the hard times, the difficult situations, the suffering, the struggling. We can make it easier. We can help. We can show the salvation of Christ through our own actions. And so when we cry out for Christ, Hosanna, save us, Christ calls back, all right, then I will call you to action. So hear that call from Christ today, friends. There's always something to celebrate as Christ moves and lives and breathes in each and every one of us. It may be raining on a Palm Sunday morning, a year into a global pandemic, but we can still take our palm branches. We can wave them high in the air, and we can celebrate the coming of the King into our lives, who moves us to do so much more in this world. No matter what is happening around us, we can celebrate the coming of Jesus Christ into this world, into our lives, into the holy city, into the kingdom of heaven. Be filled with that kingdom of heaven today, my friends, and go forth and celebrate salvation. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, my friends. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Friends, will you sing with me verses 1 and 6 of And Are We Yet Alive? Friends, Christ poured himself out for us that we might know freedom from the things that hold us down, that chain us to the things of suffering in this world, that we may be free of them. And as in freedom of those things, we are able to pour ourselves out for others, showing the way to that same freedom that we experience. And so we always take a moment to acknowledge this moment of offering on Sunday mornings. When we're inside, this is usually the moment we would collect money because it's a convenient time to do it, but this is so much more than that. This is so much more than just giving our money. This is giving ourselves. This is a moment of offering ourselves to Christ and a moment of offering ourselves to one another, to the community around us, and saying, yes, we will be the hands and feet of Jesus Christ in this world. So for all that you've poured out of yourselves, whether it is monetary or physical effort and work or just your time and energy, thank you for all you do for one another, for this community, for God. Will you sing with me now a song of praise and thanksgiving for all that we have and all that we're able to give? Let's sing the doxology. Amen, friends. We are freed in salvation because we believe in the story, the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we proclaim the fundamentals of this faith every single week when we recite the Apostles' Creed, which binds us together across all divides. So will you now recite with me the words of the Apostles' Creed and sing the Gloria Patri. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, and he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Friends, Palm Sunday is a reminder of the beginnings of salvation working in our lives. It's a week where we remember and declare the lordship of Jesus Christ over all other things in this world, and we allow him into our hearts and our lives as our King, our Lord, our Savior. So as we go forth today, let him in. Let him do the work in you and pour out that work to others, wherever you are, whoever you may come in contact with. Go in peace and love, and let's go forth singing, He is Lord. Amen.